Well, parts of the province of Cagayan experiencing heavy rainfall. Rafael Bosano is there to give us the latest. Now, Raf, over to you. Go ahead.
Hi, Carmina. Heavy rains and harsh winds greeted us as we arrived here in Cagayan Valley earlier this morning, particularly in the town of Gonzaga. We spoke to Edwin Gaspar. He's the Municipal Disaster Risk Reduction Officer of the town of Gonzaga, and he says that they've been preparing for the effects of Super Typhoon Egay for a couple of days now. The town is now on red alert with personnel on standby for possible rescue efforts. We also saw men tending to fallen trees and even wires to keep them stable in case the harsh winds continue, and it is expected to continue, and we're experiencing it right now. 11 of the 25 barangays or villages in Gonzaga are situated along the coast, which is why preemptive evacuation will be done later this afternoon, particularly for Barangays Carona, which is considered most vulnerable. Evacuation centers in different parts of the town are also ready to accommodate residents who need temporary shelter. Meanwhile, here in the town of Santa Ana, which is seen to be closest to the eye of Super Typhoon, officials are most worried about the flash floods that may happen, especially if the three rivers, namely Tangatan, Palawig, and Kasambalan, overflow. 9 out of the 16 barangays in this town are also along the coast, which is why some 100 individuals from 3 barangays have already preemptively evacuated. As of 11 a.m., signal number 4 has been hoisted here in Santa Ana, Cagayan, and Pag-asa says Egay may most likely make landfall or pass very close to the northeastern mainland Cagayan or Babuyan Islands between late this evening or Wednesday early morning. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Rafael Bosano there joining us live. Raf, to you and your team. Take care and you keep safe.